Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. If I'm a little bit pink right now, I just had a coughing fit and it will probably continue throughout this video. So whenever I cough, it makes my whole body really red. So just kind of bear with me. This is just going to be another video in my college series, but I thought I would go a little bit deeper into my university, which is Slippery Rock University. I've talked about it before. This is the university that I attend and I absolutely love it. And with my other videos, I have mentioned this and people have asked if I would do one specifically on my university, the goods and the bads. And I think I've had enough time to really understand the university, the goods and the bads, and I've really got to experience a lot of different sides of it, so I thought that this would be the perfect video. So I'm gonna go ahead and start off with the positives. I'm gonna be honest, I have had the most amazing experience at Slippery Rock University. I have gotten to do some of the craziest, most amazing things because of the university, but I'll talk about that in a little bit. So what is so great about our university is, well, for one, the size and the location. So for me, the location was great because I live so close to, so I can literally drive home anytime that I want. I film in my bedroom at my house, but yet I live on an off-campus apartment complex. But as for the size, I always tell people it's the perfect size because it's small enough that you're always seeing familiar faces, but it's large enough that you always have the opportunity to meet new people. To be honest, our campus is beautiful. It is honestly one of the prettiest campuses I have ever seen. Granted, I haven't been to too many. I'm pretty sheltered when it comes to campuses, but it's so beautiful. They make sure that the landscaping is always really nice. Like, it's just, it's so pretty. Like, there's so much green, there's so much grass. Like you can't be. Another positive is they really try to make sure that everything is accessible to students and they really want to listen to the students. So some things that they've changed within the last year would be the fact that our Boozle Express is now open 24/7 because people said, you know, if you get hungry at midnight, you don't really have that many places to go. You really don't. Quaker Steak and Lube is open until 10. The library is now open until midnight. The ARC has amazing hours. I don't know them off the top of my head, but they open at like 6 o'clock in the morning and then they don't close until like maybe 11, as well as the library during finals week is open 24/7. It's open until midnight now, but during finals week it's open 24/7. So you can literally go and you can bring your blanket, you can bring your pillow, you can bring your textbooks and your laptop, and you can just camp out at the library all finals week. And they do like fun stuff, like they have like a moonlight breakfast the Monday of finals week, just to like, it's like a dance party in Boozle and you just eat. Like even our President Norton, which you won't have because she's retiring in June, which is next month, but President Norton would always come and she would make scrambled eggs and like she would always just try to help out. The classes are small, which is awesome. The professors really tried to get to know you. I'm actually really good friends with my advisor. Like, I feel like she's actually my friend. Like, I went to her after my last breakup and we just like talked and we talked and we talked. You almost create these relationships with them, like these friendships with your professors. And they're honestly some of the coolest people you'll ever meet. The resources that we have at Slippery Rock is great. Just to give you a little recap. So we have everything's free. Like, we have a tutoring center, a 24-hour health center. We have a counseling center with extended hours. But my favorite is the Career Education and Development Center. So I recently just got an internship with Rue 21. I'm their social media intern. I don't think I would have gotten it if it wasn't for the Career Education and Development. You can bring in your resume and they'll look over your resume, and it's more of an educational thing. So they'll educate you on what you did wrong, what you need to fix, you know, things like that. I got past the resume phase and then I had a phone interview. So I went into the Career Education and Development and we just talked about possible questions they might ask me, like why Rue and like all these other things. The third one was an in-person interview. You can totally hear my dogs right now. The last one was an in-person interview. Just ignore my dogs. So I went in to the Career Education and Development. I got all dressed up and we had like a mock interview. They pretended like they were Rue 21. They were asking me all these questions and, you know, I would answer them, and at the very end of the interview they would basically tell me, this is what you should probably start working on. And they catch things that I would have never caught. They'd be like, did you realize that you said 16 times when you answered this question? Or you should really practice what to say whenever you are asked this. And another wonderful thing about our university is our clubs and organizations. So we have over 200 organizations on campus now. And those are just the registered ones. We have some that aren't even registered. It's through those organizations that I personally have been able to strive through Slippery Rock, because I've been able to do some of the coolest things. Like, I was president of the Green and White Society last year, and I was able to get a Connect to Success just because of everything that I was involved in. I was involved in President Norton's goodbye party, and just like things like that is like incredible, and I would have never been able to have those opportunities if it wasn't for the organizations that I joined. Okay, so I know that was a lot of good stuff, but that's because like I think the majority of, you know, Slippery Rock University is good. Coming to Slippery Rock, you're gonna hear people complain about four things: rain, food, water, and parking. It just happens. I'm telling you right now, it's going to happen. So the water is not very good. I will admit that, but that's not the university's fault. That is the town. Slippery Rock, PA's water is just not good. Just get a Brita filter and you won't have an issue. Slippery Rock University has water filters all over campus, so you should never have to worry about that if your water bottle doesn't have like a water filter in it. Parking. Remember when I said that there was a lot of green space and how pretty the campus was? So yeah, there's a lot of green because the parking is on the outskirts of the university. And there's some spots inside of the university as well. For the most part, for residents, I don't really think this is an issue. I think it's more commuters that have the issue with it, because there's limited spots and limited spaces, and then if you don't get those, you do park on the outskirts. But for me, I go to class 20 minutes earlier, so like if my class is at 10, I make sure that I'm at least on campus at 9:40 to make sure that I get a parking spot. Because like if you think about it, if the entire campus didn't have any green and it was all parking, I don't think I would like it as much. So like to me, I don't really complain about the parking. And I will be the first one to tell you that you have to have an umbrella with you everywhere you go. Carry an umbrella. And the last one's food. So AVI is our food company. I, once again, whenever I was a freshman, I will admit the food wasn't the best. I would go into Boozle every single day and I would eat the exact same thing because I was such a picky eater. I would eat hot dogs, hamburgers, pizza, french fries, and yogurt every single day. Like, well, maybe not in that order and maybe not that much, but I would literally eat the same foods every single day. And if you're eating the same food every single day, yes, it's gonna get boring. Not only do you have to find creative things to eat, but also AVI has been a lot better, so they listen to us. Like, I actually got to request Spaghetti Thursdays, so one Thursday every month they have like spaghetti. So that was actually my idea, so I'm really excited about that, and I would go like every Thursday just to like support it because I didn't want it to go away. They also do a mac and cheese bar, a baked potato bar. They have like a whole gluten sensitive section that they is, which is a lot better than what it was whenever I was a freshman. So they're doing a lot better. They also have a bunch of different options on their menu now. And I think, like I said, I just think a lot of people complain, and they probably don't branch out. They probably just eat the exact same food every single day. And if I ate the same food every single day, yeah, I would probably complain about the food too. So my camera is about to die, but those were the goods and the bads of Slippery Rock University. If you have any questions, please be sure to go ahead and leave them down below. I am usually a pretty speedy responder, so just leave those down there, and my camera's about to die, so bye!